Hello students, welcome to the class on Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the lead editorial. And today's lead editorial is very important because it relates to a new development with respect to data protection. First of all, we will be understanding what is data protection and how the data protection in India is related to the developments that are taking place in the European countries. First of all, let us understand data protection. Data protection. Now, before we understand the meaning of data protection, we must know what is meant by data and why the importance of data or data is increasing day by day. Few years ago, we begin to call this data as a gold mine, this data as oil, but of late we have begun to call this data as air itself. Now it means data, it has become all pervasive. Now what is meant by a data? Now suppose you will download our application, that is IAS Buzz, or you will download our other application, that is News B. In that case, you will be required to give certain information with respect to your email, and you will be also giving the permission to us to have access to your friend list. In that case, we would have a lot of information about you. We can have a lot of information about you once you will log in the application. That is our application of NewsB or IAS Buzz. Now how we will have access to the information? This is the most important thing that we must know and understand here. Now supposedly you will log in our application IAS Buzz. Now we can actually put some sort of data analytics in our application, like what kind of pages you are viewing in IAS Buzz. That will actually give us a lot of information about your psychology, what you are actually interested in, what is your viewpoint, how do you view the information that is coming out on IAS Buzz. So that by that way we will be able to map your psychology. So by data analytics tool, we can really understand and know what you are up to, what you will be liking and what you will be disliking. Now, because this is like going really deep inside you, this is like scratching your privacy, this is like digging your privacy. So this data protection, data analyzing or data analytics, this all relates to eroding your domain of privacy. Now this is very important, and this is something that requires protection, because when you are giving your data, when you're giving the information about yourself to some company, that company can really misuse that information. Like, now how the information can be misused? Now the information can be misused by processing it, because you can really process the information in a numerous way to analyze one's behavior, one's psychology, one's interests, one's likes, one's dislikes, and so many other things. So that is the reason why the countries like India or the European countries the world over, the human race is looking how to protect the data that you're giving to the companies. That data should not be misused, because that is like playing with your privacy. So this is how data protection is related to the concept of privacy. Now apart from this, a new development has taken place in European Union. They had come out, European Parliament, it had come out with a law that relates to general data protection regulation. GDPR. Now, this is very important. This is the new law that has been GDPR. This is a new law that has been framed by the European Parliament. And this law will become applicable from the month of May 2018. Now, as per this regulation of the European Union, it had pinpointed two players here. Now, the first player here is the player that we generally call as who is asking for your data, for your information. It has been called as controller. And the second player has been called as processor. Now, as per general data protection law, the controller will have to tell how your information or how your data will be used in the future. And the processor will not be allowed to mine the data in a way to actually hit into your privacy, to actually get into your privacy domain. But as far as India is concerned, now why we're discussing this editorial, we're discussing this as far as India is concerned, because European Union countries will not want the data of the citizens living in the countries in the European Union to have their data mined by the processors sitting in India. But is India really ready to control and regulate the way the processing of the data is done in India? Because when it comes to the processing of the data, most of the data processing is done in India, because outsourcing is done by the companies who actually collect a lot of data about you, and they analyze the data and they actually erode into your privacy. So primarily, in order to understand this GDPR from India's perspective, we need to know about what kind of laws we have in India with respect to data protection. Now, presently, it is only the Information Technology Act that we have in India that actually deals somewhat with this data privacy. On the other hand, or data protection, on the other hand, recently government had set up a committee under Shri Krishna committee, that is, that has put forward the guidelines of how the data protection should actually be done. But these are just the guidelines. It's nothing more than the guidelines. So presently we don't have a holistic, a foolproof, a substantive law to deal with the controller, to how to regulate controller of the data, or how to regulate the processor of the data, or how to make ourselves more compliant with the futuristic laws that are actually germinating from the countries like European Union. So now, because you might have understood from this class that how this data protection is related to privacy, and how should India be going about this, making itself compatible with GDPR. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. And the information is scrolling down here. If you want any more information about the packages, you can WhatsApp at the number floating here. That is 8459400000. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.